It's one of those really, really random vlogs. Only because we've just had a right interesting conversation and I thought to myself, oh, I should have recorded that.
This happens occasionally.
Because I do that sometimes. I was talking about Masaru Emoto.
Think so?
You ever heard of him?
As if. It's very, very random.
He has a book called Messages from Water. And there's a... We've known about him for years. In fact, I'll show you a little picture here of the water dispenser in our fridge. That all comes from this whole Messages from Water. Anyway, I was reminded of him again recently. Not like I can't be in pretty much every time I open the...
Tesco. We are going to Tesco.
Which one? Oh, right, yeah. I get you. It's me, I'm wrong. I don't drive. There's a bit of a viral kind of reel going around at the moment. This guy asking, have any of you heard of Masaru Emoto? Who's this guy who has done a lot of work with water? Basically, he's put water in different containers, and on those containers written different words. Sometimes horrible words and sometimes good words. And then frozen the water and photographed the crystals formed or when the water is thawing. And the ice crystals in the water that is labelled with good words and to which you say good things forms the most beautiful ice crystals. And the words written, the bad words written on containers, or the bad words sent in those waters.
What I was saying to Paul was, even if you don't necessarily subscribe to that belief or that kind of method, harm does it do to put the words on your water anyway?
But the thing is, it's proven, it's scientifically proven that this happens when you say negative words. And don't forget, we're mainly made of water. That's what we are. Humans are, what is it, 90% water?
This is true.
So if positive words can really positively affect water to the point where it makes beautiful ice crystals when it's frozen, and if negative words can do the exact opposite, then there's something in it. And then we got talking about the power of music. Fact, just because I know it's going to be available. Is that nice with some behind us? No, is it? just because I know it's available, I think on YouTube, I'm going to link up here a song, a piece of music from a series that we watched with Sean Penn called The First, about Mars. There you go. And this one piece of music really makes us both feel something very, very physical, doesn't it?
Yeah, and there's the whole thing around like resonance and frequencies and the alleged note that makes you poop yourself and all that kind
and
of stuff.
You've got all the ancient Egyptians. See, sometimes we have really deep conversations about life. That's why we got married, I suppose.
This is the place, by the way, where I locked the keys in the car.
Yeah.
So I shan't be doing that again.
No, I was going to say about the old Egyptian art, where it looks like all the kind of guys are carrying... Well, they look like they're carrying little handbags. And they also look like they're carrying tuning forks.
Yeah.
Big tuning forks. Yeah. big long tuning forks. So, see, I'm a believer in Earth's cyclical nature, because there's a lot of proof out there, and there are ancient ruins being found all the time that basically shit on history. Oh, we've been around about 6,000 years of civilization. No, we haven't. Because they've found stuff now 12,000 years old. And older. And older. And we've found these big meaty holes. Mm-hmm. From all these different... So...
What's the point of all of this?
Well, we've been... The point of all of this is that music is massively powerful and really important. But what you play to yourself is really important. And I think that you've got to... focus on how you feel, not whether you know something or it's familiar, but how it makes you feel.
Yes.
Like, really, does it make you feel good? Does it make you feel stronger, more powerful, happier? All good things, play the shiz out of it.
Mm-hmm.
Or if it doesn't, don't play it.
And the same with words.
And the same with words.
Yeah.
Be careful what you say to yourself. Do check out, if there's a video on YouTube, I'll link it up here, about Masaru Emoto. I'm crap with names. I always have been. But I remember the title of the book, Messages from Water, and it's fascinating. You can do your own little experiment. Boil some white rice. Do it with your kids. Put the boiled white rice in two separate jars, sealed. On one, write the word love. On the other, write the word hate. Every day, say three negative things to the hate jar. I hate you. You're ugly. Get out. Every day, say three lovely things to the love jar. I love you. You're beautiful. Thank you. Watch what happens. It might take some time, but the rice in the hate jar will start to go black. And the cooked rice in the love jar won. We're 90% water. I love you. Thank you. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now we're going to Tesco's for our tea. Sorry. Hope you enjoyed that. A random few moments with Deep Paul and Jason before they buy dinner.
Mainly Deep Paul.
Sorry, love. Be excellent to yourselves and each other. We'll see you again really soon. Bye, loves!